Yes, students. Principle of reflection. Yes, it is a reflecting surface I am taking. Reflecting surface. This is normal to reflecting surface. Normal to reflecting surface. Yes, normal light. Now, a light ray incident at an angle theta. Light ray incident at an angle theta with respect to normal on the reflecting surface. This is incident ray. Now, students, this incident ray gets reflected. This is incident ray, this is reflected ray. Angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. Students, here, how light reflected? Why angle of incidence equal to reflection? This all now, yes, before vectors are completely over. That's why I'm concentrating only remaining part. Yes, okay. Normal line, incident light ray, reflected light ray. These all in a single plane. This is first principle of reflection. All know. Second principle is angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. Angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. Students, up to here, all students know already. Now, vector form of principle of reflection, now I am concentrating. Because vectors at that time not completed, that's why this part not completed. Now, vector form of principle of reflection. Vector form, because this line is a vector. Okay, now here E bar represents vector of incident light ray. Incident light ray vector form, that is E bar. Next it is R bar. R bar is nothing but reflected light ray represented with that R bar vector. So incident light ray vector, reflected light ray vector. And these are now two vectors. We can write unit vectors also. Yes, students, here unit vector E cap. And here unit vector R cap. E cap. Unit vector in the direction of incident light ray. R cap, unit vector in the direction of reflected light ray. Yes, now this angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection, that okay. Yes, here one more unit vector I am taking, N cap. Students, N cap represents unit vector along the normal line. This is reflecting surface. This is the normal line. N cap is a normal line. N cap is a normal line. Yes, okay, now. E bar, R bar, N cap. E cap, R cap, N cap. All are unit vectors now I am taking. Unit vectors, magnitude, you know, stress, that is 1. So that's why modulus of E cap, modulus of R cap is nothing but a 1. But modulus of E bar, modulus of R bar is not 1. That is now E, that is equal to R. Yes, students, here, this E bar, modulus of E bar equal to modulus of R bar equal to, you can take now either E or E. E or R. Okay, now I am taking E simply. But E cap, R cap, N cap magnitudes already you know, that is 1 because unit vectors. Okay, now If it is a theta, students, theta, this is also theta. Now it is E bar. All students know resolution of a vector. So, vector E bar, this is theta. Theta side of E cos theta. Another side, E sin theta. Same, similar, here also. This is an angle theta, it is also angle theta. This is R bar. So that's why it is R cos theta, R sin theta. Yes, students, just this vector E bar and R bar resolve one component E cos theta, there R cos theta. These two components are parallel to normal line. But E sin theta component, R sin theta component, those two components are parallel to reflecting surface. Parallel to reflecting surface. Parallel to reflecting surface. These two perpendicular to reflecting surface means along the normal. Okay, now this is normal. Here, one more vector I am taking T cap. Students, T cap is nothing but again unit vector in the direction of, that means in the plane of reflecting surface. In the plane of reflecting surface. So n cap normal to reflecting surface, t cap is in the direction of, means in the plane of reflecting surface. These two again unit vectors. Now n cap, e bar, R bar, T cap, all are in a single plane. That plane is nothing but plane of the Bohr. Plane of the Bohr. So now all are in this plane. Okay? Yes, now students, E bar, otherwise E cap. E cap means unit vector, E bar means general vector, but both are in the direction of incident ray. Okay, I am taking now E cap. E cap, this is unit. How you write? Minus E cos theta. But here I am writing E cap, right? That's why this unit is a one unit vector. Minus cos theta n cap plus sin theta t cap. This is E cap. Similarly, R cap equal to R cap, unit vector in the direction of reflected ray. Unit vector means we know magnitude is 1. So that's why that is R means 1. Cos theta n cap plus sin theta t cap. Students, this is E cap and R cap written like that. E cap and R cap. Now, R cap minus E cap. This vector minus this vector. These two cancel out. These two cancel out. Now, cos theta minus of minus cos theta. 2 cos theta N cap. R cap minus E cap is 2 cos theta n cap. 2 cos theta n cap. Right. Here, R cap minus E cap equal to 2 n cap into, students, here cos theta. Now, E bar and n cap. Otherwise, E cap, N cap. Otherwise, R cap, N cap. Yes, here, angle between E cap, carefully observe, this is E cap, this is N cap, this angle is 180 minus theta. This is E cap, this is N cap. but n cap and r cap, this angle is a theta. Students, angle between n cap and r cap is a theta, but n cap and e cap is a 180 minus theta. At the time of measuring angle between two vectors, that two vectors should start from same point. So according to that principle, 180 minus theta, the angle between e bar, e cap and n cap is 180 minus theta. Now dot product, modulus of e cap 1, modulus of n cap 1, cos 180 minus theta minus cos theta. But here we need only cos theta. That's why students, I am writing minus e cap dot n cap. E cap dot n cap. Now r cap minus e cap equal to, that is, but we need only r cap. So r cap equal to e cap minus 2 n cap into e cap dot n cap. So this is unit vector in the direction of reflected ray. Unit vector in the direction of reflected ray, r cap equal to unit vector in the direction of incident ray, e cap minus 2 n cap. N cap is a normal unit vector. E cap dot n cap. This is r cap. Yes, r cap equal to e cap minus 2 n cap, e cap dot n cap. This is only unit vectors I explained up to now in terms of unit vectors. Yes, the same you might know general vectors also. That also here I am writing just wait. Yes, instead of e cap, e bar equal to minus e cos theta n cap plus e sin theta t cap. Next, r bar equal to r cos theta n cap plus r sin theta t cap. And the students, here modulus of e bar, modulus of r bar is nothing but the same, that is e or is r. So now e and r both are the same. That's why again r bar minus e bar equal to, these two cancel out because e equal to r. Yes, now 2 again e cos theta n cap. So therefore r bar equal to, send that e bar that side, e bar same now 2e cos theta. Yes, so students, here e cap, same e cap here, e bar, this is n cap, again angle 180 minus theta. So now e bar minus 2 n cap into e cos theta plus, I am writing e bar dot n cap, because e bar dot n cap, e into n cap is 1, cos 180 minus theta minus cos theta. So e cos theta plus minus e bar dot n cap written, that's all. So now r bar equal to e bar minus 2 n cap e bar dot n cap. Yes, so students, now need not to confuse here t cap T-cap place, suppose any confusion is there, take I-cap number. It is along x-axis, I-cap take. Yes, suppose N-cap, any now confusion, J-cap take. Indirectly, I-cap. So that is, in the plane of a reflecting surface, J-cap is perpendicular to reflecting surface. So now, but it is in a plane. So that's why one vector T cap now I have taken instead of I cap. So T cap means parallel to or in the direction of or in the plane of reflecting surface. Indirectly tangential to reflecting surface. That's why T mentioned. This is normal. Now incident ray, reflected ray. Incident ray vector magnitude, reflected ray vector magnitude, both are the same. Because this now principle of reflection was explained according to Newton's law. So in that Newton principle, in the case of reflection by elastic surfaces, there is no any change in speed, only velocity, direction only changed, same like that. Here E bar, only direction changed, no question of magnitude. So that's why modulus of E bar equal to modulus of R bar equal to E. Right, now, suppose in the examination, along the incident ray, suppose unit vector given, unit vector. Yes, follow this principle. Because it is a unit vector along the reflected ray. Suppose now, instead of giving unit vector, general vector given, then follow this. But of course, from general vector, first you can find the unit vector and then follow this. Yes, so that's why this expression, both are same only. The only difference is magnitude of E bar and R bar, that is E, not equal to 1. But here E cap means magnitude is a 1, simply magnitude is a 1. So now, reflected wave or reflected ray represented with R bar, incident ray represented with E bar. So from here to here, yes, clearly take all this now. Many problems are there. All problems one by one I will explain. Yes, come on, take that fast. Yes, so students, now here clearly understand. So now it is suppose a plane of the reflecting surface. Yes, it is plane of the reflecting surface. It is a plane of the reflecting surface. Now it is incident to light ray. Then light ray reflected. So this incident to light ray, I am resolving one component parallel to reflecting surface, and that is mirror. Another component to perpendicular to reflecting surface, that is a normal. Yes, so students, here it is one plane, because reflecting surface means one, you please imagine one reflecting, that means plane mirror, now imagine. Here plane mirror is there, ray incident and then reflected. This incident ray I am resolving into two perpendicular components. One component is parallel to reflecting surface, another component is perpendicular to reflecting surface. Perpendicular to reflecting surface in the sense normal line. So here E bar I am resolving into two components. One component along the normal, another component along the plane of reflecting surface. One is parallel to reflecting surface, another is normal to reflecting surface. But if you observe this reflected wave, this reflected ray also have two components. These two components, one is parallel to reflecting surface, another is normal to reflecting surface. Here see, parallel to reflecting surface, any change? See now, same E sin theta, same R sin theta, of course E equal to R. So that's why E sin theta, R sin theta. Parallel to reflecting surface, no change. Both in magnitude and direction also. Remember, parallel to reflecting surface, parallel to reflecting surface. No change in both magnitude and direction of incident and reflected rays. No change. But parallel to normal means perpendicular to reflecting surface. Perpendicular to reflecting surface means along the normal line. Along the normal line, before incident, see now, light ray is moving towards the reflecting surface, towards. After reflecting, see now, moving away from. So before collision, that means before incident ray is moving towards the plane, reflected ray is moving away, that means direction both opposite, magnitude same. Direction. So this is E sin theta, this is R sin theta. One is towards, another is away. So that's why now here sin theta, but cos theta minus cos theta is there. Now students remember very simple logic. Parallel to reflecting surface, no change in both magnitude and direction of vector, but normal, along the normal, perpendicular to reflecting surface, no change in magnitude, but exactly opposite in direction. One small example I will tell, just wait. Students, reflecting surface in XZ plane. Reflecting surface is in XZ plane. XZ plane means definitely normal is along either positive Y direction or negative Y direction. Because it is a XZ plane. Normal is either along positive or negative Y. So XZ plane, I am taking a reflecting surface. And normal line means n cap, taking positive Y axis. Normal line along positive Y axis. Now, incident ray E bar equal to incident ray E bar equal to 2 I cap minus 3 J cap plus 4 K cap. Now R bar. Yes, again students, yet our reflecting surface is in a XZ plane. Reflecting surface is in a XZ plane. Normal line is normal line along positive Y axis. On this mirror, one light ray represented with vector 2i cap minus 3j cap plus 4k cap. Incident on this mirror, that is XZ plane. After reflection, this is a reflected ray representation. Again with the vectors, just 10 seconds time I am giving. This R bar, students, now please write on your own. Again, I will explain. R bar, write now on your own. Fast. Just R bar, write. Just R bar. Okay, now stop. Now listen. Students, here R bar is a reflected. Now, XZ plane is a reflecting surface. Along the reflecting surface, no change in both magnitude and direction, right? So, along the reflect means XZ. That's why 2i cap, 2i cap, 4k cap. This is plus. Now, normal to XZ plane is a positive y-axis. That means y component, magnitude wise no change. Direction opposite. Student, this is a minus 3j cap converted into plus 3j cap. So now for this incident ray, E bar equal 2i cap minus 3j cap plus 4k cap. R bar equal to 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap. Yes, students, how many students now predicted this answer, R cap, R bar? Please raise your hand. I will count here. R bar, vectors, R bar. Because vector chapter already completed. Now I am applying same vectors into our geometrical optics. Yes, so more students active. Very nice. Okay, this is R. Okay, now students, for remaining students I am explaining. Just wait 1 second. Right. Now students, suppose some students unable to return this equation, it not work. Yes, now first method what I told, first reflecting surface you need to identify. Okay, identify. Along the reflecting surface, no change in both magnitude and direction. Yes, here XZ means I component, K component, no change. But normal direction, magnitude no change, direction opposite. That's why minus 3j cap becomes plus 3j cap. Okay, leave that. Now come to here this vector. R bar equal to E bar minus 2n cap, E bar dot n cap, one equation also you have. So that equation, students, 1 second, that equation here, students, E bar what given? 2i cap minus 3j cap plus 4k cap given. E bar, okay? Now, minus 2 into n cap. Students, n cap is positive, y means now j cap, right? So that's why 2j cap. E bar dot n cap, dot product. E bar dot n cap. 2 into 0, 0. Minus 3 into plus 1. That is now minus 3. So now here, minus 3 come. E bar dot n cap. E bar dot n cap. Minus 3. Now, 2i cap minus 3j cap plus 4k cap minus minus plus 3 into 2, 6j cap. Students, minus 3j cap plus 6j cap plus 3j cap, right? So that's why any students now unable to find direct this equation, suppose. Need not to already one equation we have. R bar equal to E bar. E bar means incident. Yes, already given. Minus 2n cap. Unit vector normal to the plane. Yes, already given. Positive y-axis means j cap. Positive y means j cap. Yes, j cap. E bar dot n cap is a dot product. All we know dot product, right? Ax, bx plus ay, by plus az, bz. Yes, now by using either this equation or directly like this, now you will find. Yes, student, this is example number one. One more example I will tell, just wait. This one completed now. Yes, you please take this example first. Come on. Yes, here one more example I'm explaining. One more example. Suppose E bar equal to incident ray. E bar equal to I cap plus 2J cap minus 3K cap. I cap plus 2J cap minus 3K cap. So this is incident ray given, incident ray. And normal unit vector, normal unit vector n cap minus I cap minus j cap divided by root 2 given. Students, minus I cap minus j cap by root 2 is a unit vector. So this is normal. So E bar given, n cap also given. Now our target is R bar, reflected ray, vector representation we need. Yes, here R bar equal to question. How to find R bar? Now this problem is difficult, that's why by using this now easily you can't find it. So your option should be this. Yes, R bar equal to E bar minus 2 n cap E bar dot n cap. But what is E bar? Yes, E bar already given. I cap plus 2 j cap minus 3 k cap minus 2 into n cap. Yes, n cap already there. Minus I cap minus j cap by root 2. Yes, here 2 into. So that's why root 2 here 2. Already here this minus and here minus cancel plus root 2 into I cap plus j cap up to here. Now E bar dot n cap. E bar dot product, because here k is there, here no k, that's why this need not run. Now E cap dot n cap I that means here minus 1 by root 2. Here minus 2 by root 2 means root 2. So now root 2 into minus 1 by root 2 minus root 2. Now suppose if you take now, yes, here minus 1 by root 2 common. This root 2 cancel out. Now here minus 1, minus 2. Minus 1, minus 2. Yes, how much? Minus 3. Now here minus 3 into I cap plus J cap. Yes, finally now answer I am writing, students. R bar equal to, yes, here again root 2 minus outside 1 plus 2, 3. Root 2 cancel. Minus 3 I cap minus 3 I cap minus 2 I cap 2 j cap minus 3 j cap 2 j cap minus 3 j cap minus j cap minus 3k cap, that's it. This is final reflected. This is final reflected ray. R bar equal to E bar. Yes, E bar as it is. Minus 2 n cap. 2 into root 2 means root 2. Minus common here, minus plus root 2 into I cap plus j cap into E bar dot n cap. E bar dot n cap dot product. Yes, now minus 2 I cap, minus j cap, minus 3 k cap. This is reflected ray representation. Minus 2 I cap, minus j cap, minus 3 k cap. Right, students, now suppose now like this, now either xy plane, xz plane, zx plane given, easily you can now write reflected ray like this. Suppose any complicated given, not xz plane, some plane like this. See, normal is now minus I cap minus j cap by root 2. Like that, now any different plane given, then this is the principle. That's why all students, please remember, R bar, that is vector representing reflected ray after reflection from the mirror or reflecting surface, E bar incident vector minus 2 n cap. N cap means normal to the reflecting surface into dot product of E bar and N cap. E bar and N cap. E bar and N cap. So this is now R bar. Complete R bar. So now incident ray, normal line. Incident ray, normal line given. Reflected ray you can find out. Reflected ray you can find out. In the same way, suppose incident ray, reflected ray given, unit vector along the normal we need, that is n cap we need. That is also an example I will tell just for you. Yes, so students, this example, please now write first, and once the class is completed, now you need to analyze these two again. And by using now this, now you take another values and solve different problems. Yes, first one and two take reflected ray. Next one more now. N cap how to find, I will explain. Come on, take that. Okay, now. Yes, R bar equal to E bar minus, this is okay, fine. Students, suppose examiner unit vector asked, very simple. It's now vector divided by its magnitude is a unit vector, so need not to worry. Now next to, this equation now analyze now. R cap minus E cap equal to 2 cos theta n cap. R cap minus E cap equal to 2 cos theta n cap. Students, here R cap, unit vector along the reflected ray. E cap, unit vector along incident ray. So therefore n cap equal R cap minus E cap divided by 2 cos theta. This 2 cos theta, R cap minus E cap modulus of R cap minus E cap, you can take. because 2 cos theta is a magnitude of r cap minus e cap. R cap minus e cap. See, check, you can check. R cap means unit vector, cos theta. Minus half minus cos theta. 2 cos theta. So therefore, n cap unit vector along normal to the mirror or normal to the reflecting surface. N cap equal to R cap minus E cap by modulus of R cap minus E cap. Not only that, N cap equal to R bar minus E bar divided by modulus of R bar minus E bar. You need not to consider unit vector subtraction. Suppose if you take general vector subtraction divided by its magnitude. Because R bar minus E bar, modulus of R bar minus E bar. Yes, now N cap you can find from either unit vector subtraction or general vector subtraction also. Why means? Students, magnitude of R bar, magnitude of E bar both same only. No? That's why R bar minus E bar, how you write? Suppose R take common. R and E both are same. R cap minus E cap again. Divided by its magnitude is R. So that's why again R cancel. Then you will get same answer. So unit vector along the normal, yes, either R cap minus E cap by this magnitude or R bar minus E bar by this magnitude. Okay? Right. Suppose now one example. Suppose E bar, example, E bar equal to I cap plus J cap minus K cap. That is E bar. Now R bar equal to minus I cap minus 2 J cap. Suppose minus K cap, like this is. So this is E bar, this is R bar. E bar given, R bar given. Now I need N cap. Yes, N cap students, R bar minus E bar, R bar minus E bar, minus I cap, minus I cap, minus 2 I cap. Minus 2 J cap, minus J cap, minus 3 J cap, minus K cap, that is 0. So now divided by its magnitude root over 2, 2, 4, 3, 3, 9. So total 30. So minus 1 by root 13 into 2 I cap plus 3 J cap. This is now N cap. N cap. N cap equal to minus 1 by root 13, 2 I cap plus 3 J cap. This is unit vector normal to the reflecting surface. Yes, so students, here today complete class focused on only vector form of principle of reflection. Every equation, now some examples I told like problems. Now based on this, now you also take some numbers and solve now your own problem. Yes, now small revision. Reflecting surface, normal line, incident ray, reflected ray. Incident ray, normal line, reflected ray, and now this P cap, all are in a single plane, that is plane of the board. That is now first principle. Second principle, angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection, second principle. Board. Now vector format, E bar and R bar, how related? Yes, now incident ray, represented by this E bar, that incident where now I am resolving into two components. One component parallel to reflecting surface, another is perpendicular to reflecting surface. Parallel to reflecting surface, no any change both in magnitude and direction. But normal to the reflecting surface, magnitude no change, but direction change, opposite. So now, incident ray, normal ray, suppose given, reflected ray how to find? Reflected ray R bar equal to incident ray E bar minus 2 n cap into E bar dot n cap. E bar minus 2 n cap, E bar dot n cap. This is reflected ray identification. Suppose incident and reflected given. How to find a unit vector normal to the surface? N cap equal to R bar minus E bar by this, otherwise R cap minus E cap by that. Yes, students. Now this is principle of reflection in complete vector format. On this, some problems I will give. You need to now solve all the complete problems in the assignment. Then vector form complete. Remaining